In this lecture, we are going to see the single cycle data path design for branch instruction. Right? So, in the previous lecture, we have seen the data path design for data processing instruction. Now, we are going to see for branch instruction. So, this is a binary encoding or instruction encoding for branch. Here, it is shown for branch and branch with link. Now, for time being, we are not considering branch with link. You are using only a branch that is unconditional branch. It is same as go to instruction. So, you will be giving the instruction format will be B and then a 24-bit offset and a condition field. So, you will be giving branch instruction, then 24-bit offset will be given. So, by executing this, your program counter will be pointing to the program counter plus this 24-bit offset, right? So your offset will be your base address will be the program counter value plus this 24-bit offset will be done. So for incorporating branch instruction also into the previous architecture, you are modifying the diagram like this. So here what you should do is, for the branch instruction, you need to add the program counter value with 24-bit offset. So, program counter value should be given as input to A1, right? Program counter register value, program counter register should be configured as input to A1. So, the program counter value will be getting an output of RD1. So, for connecting program counter to RA1, you are adding one more multiplexer here, right? So this multiplexer is used for selecting whether 16 to 19 that bit should be sent to A1 or program counter value that is a content of R15. Content of R15 will be nothing but program counter plus 8. That means it is pointing to the next instruction. So R15 is nothing but R15 is represented as 15 here, right? So R15 content is program counter plus 8, right? So you are configuring R15 here as input to RA1. So for configuring R15, you are using the 2 bits for register source. Previously, register source was having only 1 bit for configuring this. In the previous example, register source was only 1 bit in the case of data processing instruction, because only one multiplexer was there. But now the register source, you are adding one more bit because you are adding one more register, and that bit should be 1. So R15 will be connected to RA1. So the content of R15, that is nothing but PC plus 8, will be available here. So the PC plus 8, that is a program counter value of the next instruction, will be available here. To this, you need to add the 24-bit immediate value. Previously, you are adding only 8-bit. In the load, you are adding only 12-bit. In load, you are adding 12-bit. In data processing, you are adding 8-bit. Here, you need to add 24-bit. So, same sign extender you can use, but one more bit you are using for configuring that. Previously, only 1 bit was there. Right? Here, you can see only 1 bit was there, because you are going to configure whether 8-bit sign extension is required or 12-bit sign extension is required. But here you need to have 3 combinations: 8-bit, 12-bit or 24-bit. In branch, you need to have 24-bit. So one more bit you are adding. So image source is having 2 bits. So this is a table showing the image source encoding. So image source is 00. That means you will perform 24-bit sign extension, 8-bit sign extension. If the image source is 01, you will perform 12-bit sign extension. And if the image source is 10, you will perform 24-bit sign extension. So in our case, I need to give image sources 10. So these are the 3 combinations of sign extension you can perform. For branching, you need to give it as 10. For 24-bit sign extension, so it is 24-bit sign extension 10. So 24-bit sign extended value you should give here. So this should be connected to source B. So what should be ALU source? It should be 1. Previously in the data processing instruction with register addressing, ALU source was 0 because you are connecting RD2 to source B. But here you need to connect sine extended output to source B. So ALU source should be 1. Right? So here you are getting the PC content, R15 content. Through this you are getting 24-bit sine extension. These two you are adding, so you should performly addition. So ALU control should be 0 0, right? You are performly adding, so ALU control should be 0 0, and the result you should send it to the program counter, right? Result, ALU result, there is a result of 24-bit addition, 24-bit immediate value with the program counter value. The result should be sent to program counter input. So what you will take? The ALU result, that you are that should be sent to program counter PC dash. So that result you are taking like this, and here the multiplexer should be given with 0. So memory to register should be 0. So the added or the updated PC value will be sent through this and will be sent as PC source. So what will happen? The new PC will be pointing to the new address, so that branching will happen. So what should be the PC source here? PC source should be 1. You should not give 0, right? Because PC source should be 1. Why? Because the ALU result should be taken as input to the PC. So PC source should be 1, right? So that is what is happening in branch operation. So you are reading the R15 content by connecting it to A1. So R15 you will get here, then you are getting the 24 bit immediate value here. Both these values you are adding in order to get the new program counter value. That value you are sending through this multiplexer by giving the control signal as 0. That value you are sending as input to the program counter. So PC source should be 1, right? So for the branch operation, you should give register source value as 10, or first bit should be 1. So the program counter value will be sent to RA1. Program counter value is nothing but PC plus 8. Then register write should be 0 because you are not writing anything here. IM source, immediate source, should be 10. 10 means you are performing 24 bit immediate value sine extension with the 24 bit immediate value. ALU source should be 1 because 24 bit immediate value should be sent to source B. So ALU source should be 1. Then ALU control should be 0 0, because for branch you are adding PC content with the 24 bit value. So only addition should be done. So 0 0 should be given to ALU control. Memory write should be 0 because you are not writing anything to data memory, right? You are only taking the result and sending to PC. So memory to register should be 0 because you need to take the data through this path. So to memory to register should be 0. That final updated PC should be sent to the PC dash. So in order to connect it to PC dash, this should be 1. PC source should be 1. So these are the control signals you need to configure for configuring B branch operation. So this is the final circuit diagram, right, or the micro architecture where you are incorporating all load instruction, store instruction, then data processing instruction and branch instruction using a single cycle processor. So this is a final single cycle processor architecture, right? So this is a architecture, and this is a final data path for the single cycle architecture. So this data path diagram incorporates all the data processing instruction, load, store and branching instruction, right? So this will be the final data path design for single cycle processor. So this is a data path design. The next lecture onwards you will see how to design the control unit. Now you have seen only the data path design. So in the next lecture, we will be seeing how to design a control unit.